Okay, very good morning all of you. Let's start with today's session. Now yesterday we solved this third exercise, and that we did it using multiple if-else, right? In that question only they have mentioned try to solve the same question using switch cases. Okay. So now I'll just quickly give you the syntax of switch case. What is difference in Java switch case and C++ switch case? That too I'll tell you, and then we'll try to solve it, the same exercise using switch case. Okay. Now, whenever you want to match the result of an expression with some constant value. You have some expression and you want to match the result of that expression with some fixed value, fixed constant value, then it is preferred to use switch case. Getting? So now the syntax of switch case I will tell you. Switch will write keyword switch, then you are going to pass an expression to it. Okay, then the body of the switch case will start. Open brace, then case is a keyword, okay, and then the constant case label, we'll call it as case label, label one. Then the statements or statement, and there has to be a provision to come out of this switch after that case part is executed. So there is break. Now if you don't put break, syntax error won't come. There is no syntax error if you don't put break. Only the thing is it will do fall through. Fall through means it will continue running the next case labels also. Getting? Now this way you can have multiple case labels, again statement or statements, provision to come out of it, break, and this can go on. And last, optional, you can have default. There also you'll have some statement and then the block is over. Okay. Now what will be the order of execution, how the execution is? The first, this expression is evaluated at runtime. Okay. Understand guys, it will run the expression and the result of the expression is matched with this label. Okay, so the result of the expression is matched with the label, and with whichever label value that expression matches, its statements are run. Okay, so it will match this expression. First the expression is evaluated. Okay, the result of the expression is matched with these labels, and with whichever label that expression matches, its statements are run. And if there is a break, it will come out of that switch. But if there is no break, there will be a fall through. Fall through means guys, it will continue running the next case labels also, and in next cases also, till it doesn't get break. Getting? Like suppose if you have written case 3, then some code is there, but no break is there. Then case 5 is there. Okay? And then there is case 9. Here some code and then break is there. Okay? Now, if your expression is matching with 3, if the result of the expression is matching with 3, it will run this code. But as there is no break, it will fall through. Okay, and it will continue running the next case also. Again, there is no break. Continue running next. There is a break, now it will come out. Means actually your expression is matched with case label 3. You understanding guys? It is matched with case label 3. Therefore, it is running this statement. But you have not given any provision to come out. That is break. Therefore, there is a fall through. And it is continue running the next case label, next cases also. So case 5 is also run, case 9 is also run, and as there is a break, it will come out. Getting? So that is the thing to be remembered. Now the conditions, I'll just tell you, this expression till Java 1.5, before 1.5, when 1.5 onwards, but before 1.5, this expression was supposed to be strictly a non-long integer constant. See ya guys, the expression is strictly supposed to be non-long integral constant. Getting? Means the result of that expression has to be an integral, and that too non-long. So who will come in non-long integral constant? Getting? Non-long integral constant, byte, short, int and char. Only these four are allowed, because these four are first of all integral and they are non-long. So float, double, long, it is not allowed. Now that was the criteria till 1.5. Now from 1.5 onwards, they have allowed enum and string also. Means 1.5 onwards, okay, expression can be string object, it can be a string object or enumerated also, like enums, enumerated data types. So they can be enums also or string also from 1.5. But still, in case labels, you cannot have floats and doubles, and it should be strictly constant only. Getting guys? Take care. Okay, so first of all, you got it. So at the beginning, what is executed? Tell me expression. The result of the expression is matched with the label. Okay, and with whichever label the expression matches, its statements are run. And if there is a provision to come out, like break, so it will come out of switch and continue with the remaining code. But if there is no break, there will be a fall through and it will continue running the next cases also. It will continue running the next cases till it doesn't get break. Okay. Now this default is optional. This is executed when none of the labels are matched with the expression. Means with the expression, if no label match, then it will run the default. You need to have default, is not compulsory. Means default is an optional part. Default is not compulsory. Default aslas paije, asa kahi garaj nahi hai. Getting? Means in your switch case, there is compulsory default supposed to be there, is not such case. And this default is to be at the end only. There is no such criteria. Getting? So default can be somewhere in between beginning also. It can be at the beginning also. It can be somewhere in between also. Doesn't matter. Getting? So first of all, default runs when none of the label match, then default run. Default is optional. No compulsion. It is to be put at the last only. It can be anywhere. Getting? And these labels are supposed to be strictly constant only. Till one point, before 1.5, it was non-long integer constant. Getting? Till 1.5, it was non-long integer constant. Take care? Okay. And from 1.5 onwards, they have allowed the expression to be string also or enum also. Okay? Now just quickly tell me, and duplicate labels are not allowed. Like if I am writing case 5 and I am writing case 2 plus 3, will this make a duplicate case? Yes, 2 plus 3 is 5 and this is also 5. So when the duplicate case come, it will not allow. Getting guys? So duplicate cases are not allowed. Okay? Then the cases are strictly supposed to be constant. You cannot have variables. So tell me, all these are invalid cases. Huh? Tell me, case 4.5. Is it invalid? Case फोर एल, ठीक है, केस वेरिएबल आई, केस सच बुलियन एक्सप्रेशंस, गेटिंग, ऑल दीज आर इनवैलिड, यस नो गाइस, टेल मी, केस 4.5, इज इट इनवैलिड, यस, बिकॉज दे आर सेइंग इट शुड बी नॉन लॉन्ग इंटीजर कॉन्स्टेंट, तो इट इज अ डबल वैल्यू, 4L इज अ लॉन्ग, दिस इज अ वेरिएबल, वेरिएबल नॉट अलाउड, एक्सप्रेशंस नॉट अलाउड, दिस एक्सप्रेशन, इट्स अ एक्सप्रेशन इवैल्यूएटेड एट रन टाइम, इट इज नॉट अलाउड, हाँ, बट कॉन्स्टेंट एक्सप्रेशन अलाउड लाइक 3 + 4, वाई, बिकॉज दिस आंसर इज ऑलवेज कॉन्स्टेंट, तो दिस इज अलाउड, बट सच एक्सप्रेशन आर नॉट अलाउड, आई लेस देन 4, और आई एम राइटिंग केस आई greater than 5 and I less than 10. These are all invalid cases. Getting? But if I am writing valid cases, case 3 I am writing, or case single quote A I am writing, okay, or case Ram I am writing, these are all valid. Why? Because this is a constant integer, this is a character, single quote, na? It's a character, so character comes na? In non-long integer constant. Double quote Ram string is allowed from 1.5 onwards, getting? So all these are valid, okay? I hope it is clear. And tell me, are these all case labels to be in the order only? No such hard and fast rule. Like if you are having case 5 first and then case 1, doesn't matter, okay, they are not supposed to be strictly in order, okay. So to quickly wind up with, just tell me quickly fast what the rules are. First of all, tell me how the execution is. Is the expression evaluated first? Is the result of the expression matched with this label? And the expression matched with the label, and with whichever label it matches, its statements are run. And if there is a provision to come out, like break, it will come out. And if there is no break, it will be a fall through. And fall through means it will continue running the next cases also, till it doesn't get break or till the switch case doesn't get over. Okay, then these labels are supposed to be strictly constants. Till one point, before 1.5, it was non-long integer constant. Now after that, they have allowed you to use enums and strings also. Okay, but strictly constant. So here if float come, or a variable come, or an expression come, it is not allowed. Right? It should be a strictly constant value. Okay. And all the labels are supposed to be in order, no such hard and fast rule. Default is a optional, getting? It is executed when none of the label match. In every switch, default has to be there, is not compulsory. It is to be at the last, also not compulsory. We can insert it anywhere, getting? So it is optional, you can insert it anywhere, not necessary it is to be put at the last only. Getting? So all the things are clear to you now, right? Okay, so just give me quick confirmation, all the criteria, conditions of switch case of Java, are they clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Sure. Okay, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now to try to solve this same question, the same one, okay, using switch case, because you have an option A is given using multiple if else and B is given using switch case, okay. So yesterday we have solved one print number in word. Let us go. supposed to open it. Print number in Word. Now this we did it yesterday using if else. Now what I'll do is I'll put this much part in a comment and I'll write the same program using switch case. But please understand the criterias. Like after 1.5, from 1.5 onwards, they have allowed string as a case label. They have allowed enums also as a case label. Before that, the case labels were supposed to be non-long, integer, constant. So case as a float, case as a variable, case as an expression, not allowed. Duplicate cases, not allowed. Okay? And can the entire switch case be empty also? Yes. Empty switch case is also allowed. Please remember true-false statement they can ask. Now I'll write a switch to which I'll pass this number as a expression. Right? And then we will write the case label. The case 0, in that I'll write system.out.println 0. And I'll give a provision to come out of the loop. Okay? So I'm giving the provision to come out of the loop, to come out of the switch case. So I've given break. If you don't give break, I told you what will be there? Fall through. Fall through means Fall through sometimes you have to implement in coding. Fall through sometimes is necessary. You understanding? Like sometimes you want to run the same code for three case labels. Like suppose your case label is 4, case label is 9, and case label is 11. But for all three, you want to run the same code. Your code is same. For label 11 also, 9 also, and 4. So you have to put a fall through only. Case 4, nothing is there. Not even break. Will it fall through and come here only? Getting? So for 4 also, for 9 also, for 11 also, the same code will be run. Okay, but now like C, they have not given the range mechanism. If you remember in C, we can give range also, no? Yes or no, guys? 4.9. Is there such provision? I'm sure many might not be knowing. But in C, we have such a range giving provision. Java doesn't give such thing. Okay? Now case 0, so I'll just copy paste it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, default. Okay? I'll just change the case numbers. Okay, now this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8, 9, and this is case label default. Default, it is not mandatory to be written at the end only. You can write default anywhere. Generally, we write at the last, but it is, the syntax doesn't say that it is to be written at the last only. Anywhere you can write. Getting? And there is no need to put a break after default, because anyway, default you have written at the end. So after running default, the switch is going to get over only. Okay, so here I'll put other. Okay, then 9, 8, 7. Okay, then 2, and last is 1. Okay? And now run this. Hope it is visible to you guys. See ya. Go to D drive, your folder JAVAC print number in Word, Java print number in Word. It is asking for the input. Suppose I give 7. Is it printing 7? I give input 9. It is printing 9. I give 0. It's printing 0. But I am giving 23. Is it giving other? So accordingly the working is. Okay. So as you gave input as 9. Okay. So it is matched with case 9. And it has run this part. And there is break. Therefore it is coming out. Okay. Hope it is clear. So let's move on to the next thing. Now in this case they are saying write a program called print day in Word, which prints Sunday, Monday if the integer variable day is 0 to 6. Otherwise it shall print not a valid day. Now this also obviously you will do it using switch case. Okay. Yes or no guys? So I think so. No need to solve it. It's quite simple. Isn't it? I hope you people can try it. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Confirmation if you can try. It's quite simple question. Okay. Then let's move on to the next thing. Now next is that write a program called sum and average to produce the sum of 1 to an upper bound. The upper bound you can accept from the user. Here example 100 they have taken. Okay, and also compute and display the average. The sum and average. The output should look like this. Okay, so now here we have to find out the sum of 1, then 2, so 1 plus 2, 3, then 3 plus 3, 6, then 6 plus 4, 10. So this way the summation you have to go on taking. So obviously we have to go for some repetitive instructions or iterative instructions, right? So what are the different iterative instructions provided by Java? Okay, so repetitive instructions means performing something again and again for some number of times or till some condition doesn't satisfy. Okay, so what all different types of loops were provided in C? If you have studied, just give me the feedback. Okay. If you have discussed different types of loops in C, they are exactly same in Java also. Exactly the same, nothing else. Okay, so have you studied some repetitive instructions or iterative instructions?
Fibonacci series.
No, but that was a program, that was an application. Fibonacci series is an application. I'm saying the types of loops you have studied or no in C. Different types of loops. Yes.
Huh. For loop, while loop.
Yes, for loop, while loop, do while loop.
Do while loop.
Yes or no? That's what? The same, exact same are there in Java. Syntax also they haven't changed. It is exactly same. Get it? So there is while loop, there is for loop, there is do while loop. Okay? Everything is same. See, so there is one loop called as a while loop, which is an entry control. So while, then the condition, and then the statement. Getting? So that statement can be a single statement or it can be more than one. So if it is more than one, you have to put a block. Block means open brace, close brace. You have to write it within a block. Okay. So statement can be one statement or more than one. If it is more than one, obviously you have to put it in a block. How do we make a block? By open brace, close brace, right? This is an entry controlled loop, entry controlled. Why? Because the condition for termination, the condition for termination is tested at the beginning only. Is it tested at the beginning? Yes. Therefore, here the statements will get executed how many times? 0 or more times. Why I am saying 0 or more times? Because at the beginning only, the condition may be फॉल्स. तो इफ एट द बिगिनिंग ओनली इफ द कंडीशन इज फॉल्स द स्टेटमेंट मे नॉट रन फॉर सिंगल टाइम ऑल्सो. अंडरस्टैंडिंग गाइज? तो इफ योर कंडीशन एट द स्टार्ट ओनली इज फॉल्स इट मे नॉट रन द स्टेटमेंट्स फॉर अ सिंगल टाइम ऑल्सो. ओके, देयरफॉर आई हैव स्टेटेड हियर जीरो और मोर टाइम्स, राइट? तो एट द बिगिनिंग वॉट इज टेस्टेड द कंडीशन, एंड इफ द कंडीशन इज ट्रू इट विल परफॉर्म द स्टेटमेंट एंड अगेन कम बैक टू चेक द कंडीशन. मीन्स इट विल कीप रिपीटिंग द स्टेटमेंट्स टिल द कंडीशन इज ट्रू, एंड वेन द कंडीशन बिकम फॉल्स इट विल कंटिन्यू विद द रिमेनिंग कोड. वॉट एवर कोड इज आफ्टर दैट व्हाइल लूप इट विल कंटिन्यू विद द रिमेनिंग कोड. यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग? क्लियर? तो एट द बिगिनिंग वॉट इज टेस्टेड आई जस्ट ट्राई टू शो यू विद अ फ्लो चार्ट. तो व्हाइल लूप एग्जीक्यूट्स द ब्लॉक हाउ मेनी टाइम्स गाइस? वन और मोर और जीरो और मोर?
Zero or more times.
Zero or more times. Why I'm saying zero or more time? Why zero or more? Why not one or more?
Whose condition can be false at the beginning?
The condition for termination can be false at the beginning only. So that time it may not run the code for a single time also. Correct? So always at the entry, what is tested? Condition is tested. Getting? At the entry, it will test the condition. I'm just trying to draw a flow chart. Okay? This is your condition. The outcome of that condition can be true or false. Yes or no. Getting? So it can be false, it can be true. If it is false, then it will continue with the following code, whatever code is after the while loop. But true, then it is going to perform the statements, getting? And again come back to check the condition, getting? So at the entry, it tests the condition, true, perform the statement, and again come back to check the condition. This it will keep repeating, this it will keep repeating till the condition is true. And if the condition is false, it will continue with the remaining code. So at the beginning only the condition can be false. At the beginning only the condition is false. So it may not run the statement for a single time also. It will directly go to the remaining code. Understanding? Clear? Okay, so I hope you are understanding it. And if true, perform the statement, come back. Now generally remember, within the statement only you have to write some statements which will make in the near future condition false. Means in your statement body you have to write some statement because of which this condition in the future is going to become false. Otherwise what will happen? Will it go into an infinite loop? If in your statement you are not writing some code because of which this condition will become false, then it may enter into an infinite loop. It will keep running the same code again and again. Okay? Theek hai. So I hope you got it. And generally this condition is made up of, within this condition, it can be relational operators, logical operators, but the condition has to be a Boolean expression only. Yeah? Such while loops are not allowed, which are allowed in other languages. Like in C and all, we can write while one. In C, writing while one is true. It is legal. Why? Because in C, there is no concept called Boolean data type, true or false. There, it is non-zero or zero. So C says one is non-zero, it is true. Such things are not allowed. The same thing if you try to write in Java, it will give a incompatible type, it will say found integer, required Boolean. Getting guys? So here the strictly condition has to be Boolean. Okay, so generally that condition is involved with a variable called as counter, or it's called as a loop controlling variable. okay, or we also call it as indices also. So there is something called counter. The counter is a variable which is keeping the count of how many times the iterations are done till now. So till now how many repetitions are done, or till now how many iterations are done, that is kept, that track is kept by the counter, getting? And therefore that counter is called as a loop controlling variable. And generally these counters are used in that condition. Means within this condition, generally who are there? That counters are there. And in this statement, that counters are getting updated. And they are updated in such a way that in the near future, the condition will become false. You understanding? Clear? Okay. Just a simple example to give here. Okay. Now, suppose I want to print 1 to 5. Okay, so I'll create one integer variable, I equal to 1. So this is the initialization part. I'm initializing that I to 1, and I want to display from 1 till 5. Isn't it? So I want to display 1 to 5, so I have to keep a count, no, that whether the printing is done 5 times or no. Whether the printing is done 5 times or no. So who is going to keep the count of it? I. So I will be called as a counter. Or it is called as a loop controlling variable. Then I'll write a while loop. Then the entry condition I less than equal to 5. And then in a body, I'm going to write system dot out dot println I. And after every iteration, I'm incrementing I. This is that statement. This is that statement because of which your while loop in the near future is going to stop. Otherwise, see here, if you don't write this statement, getting? So is your I going to reach to 5? No, it will be 1. 1 less than equal to 5, it will print 1. Come up, still it is 1 less than equal to 5, print 1. So 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, infinite times it will get printed. That is the reason you have to write this statement, I plus plus. When you write I plus plus, this condition in the near future is going to become false. You understanding? Because your I is approaching towards 5. It was 1, then it's becoming 2, then 3, then 4, then 5, and then 6. And the moment it becomes 6, the condition becomes false and the loop stops. Getting, guys? Okay? So initially I is how much? 1. Then it will test the condition. Is the condition true? Yes, 1 is less than equal to 5. It will print 1, increment, make it 2. I becomes 2. Again come and check, is 2 less than equal to 5? Yes. Print 2, make it 3. This will go on, then 4, then 5. Now finally it has printed 5 and now it makes it 6. Till 5 it has printed. And now it makes I plus plus 6. Come here. Is 6 less than equal to 5? No. The while loop will stop and it will continue with the remaining code. Getting? So now in this case, at the beginning only, if the value is not 1, it is 10. Will it enter in the loop body? No. Because at the beginning only the condition is false. So as it is false, it may not run this whole body for a single time also. You understanding? Clear? So I hope you is clear to you. So who is the loop controlling variable here? I, also called as a counter. And is this I involved in this condition? Yes. And is this I getting updated? Yes, such that in the near future this condition will become false. Means is this I approaching towards 5? And as this I is approaching towards 5, one stage will come when the condition will become false. Agreed? So hope the concept of while loop is clear to you. In this only, tell me if I am shifting this I plus plus in this SOP only, will it do? Then is there any need to write a while brace bracket? No. See here, I equal to 1. Is 1 less than equal to 5? Yes. Print I and increment. It is post increment. गाइज इट इज पोस्ट इंक्रीमेंट, तो विल इट गिव द वैल्यू ऑफ आई एंड देन इंक्रीमेंट, तो इट विल गिव यू द वैल्यू ऑफ आई एज वन एंड मेक इट टू, वन प्रिंटेड एंड आई इज इंक्रीमेंटेड, इट हैज बिकम टू. एग्रीड? यस और नो?
यस सर.
क्लियर? सपोज इन द सेम थिंग आई वुड हैव डन लाइक दिस, दिस इज जीरो एंड आई एम राइटिंग आई प्लस प्लस हियर, विल दैट ऑल्सो डू? यस इट विल डू. बट वाइल चेकिंग द कंडीशन, वाइल चेकिंग द कंडीशन इट विल टेक द ओल्ड वैल्यू बिकॉज इट इज पोस्ट इंक्रीमेंट. ठीक है, तो वॉट इज आई? जीरो. इज जीरो लेस देन इक्वल टू फाइव? इज जीरो लेस देन इक्वल टू फाइव? यस. बट वेन इट एंटर्स इन साइड आई इज इंक्रीमेंटेड, इट इज पोस्ट इंक्रीमेंटेड. तो वाइल चेकिंग इट इज यूजिंग ओल्ड आई, बट आई गेट्स इंक्रीमेंटेड. तो जीरो लेस देन इक्वल टू फाइव, यस. बट वेन इट एंटर्स इन द बॉडी आई हैज बिकम वन, आई इज इंक्रीमेंटेड. अंडरस्टैंडिंग? टू सी हाउ द वेरिएशन यू कैन डू. ना द सेम थिंग आई रोट आई प्लस प्लस सेपरेटली, आई रोट आई प्लस प्लस ईयर, आई रोट आई प्लस प्लस ईयर, ऑल पॉसिबिलिटीज आर देयर. ओके, देन वी हैव डू आई लूप ऑल्सो. इज डू आई लूप एग्जिट कंट्रोल्ड? Do while loop is called as a exit controlled. Okay, but this while loop and do while loop both come under logically controlled loop. They are called as logically controlled. Logically controlled means they perform the iteration till some condition doesn't become false. So the number of iterations are not known. It will keep repeating till some condition doesn't become false. And the for loop is there. ओके, तो फॉर लूप इज जनरली कॉल्ड एज अ एन्यूमरेशन कंट्रोल, बिकॉज फॉर लूप इज जनरली यूज फॉर सम नंबर ऑफ टाइम्स. तो नाउ आई विल टेल यू द डू व्हाइल लूप सिंटैक्स. डू स्टेटमेंट और स्टेटमेंट्स एंड देन व्हाइल ब्रैकेट कंडीशन सेमीकोलन. ठीक है, अगेन इन अ डू व्हाइल लूप प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड, if there is only single statement, no need to put bracket. Many people have a wrong impression that for a do while loop you have to put a bracket. No such hard and fast rule. You're understanding when to put a bracket? When there are more than one statement, then put bracket. If it is having only one statement, no need to put bracket over there. Okay, and do while loop, how it works? Exit controlled means it tests the condition at the exit. Therefore, it's going to run the code how many times? Zero or one time or one or more time? Zero or more or one or more? It is one or more. Means at the beginning only if the condition is false, then also it is going to run the statement at least once. Understanding, guys? ठीक है? तो pictorially if I try to show you or in a flowchart form, तो फर्स्ट एट द एंट्री ओनली इट इज गोइंग टू परफॉर्म द स्टेटमेंट्स. द स्टेटमेंट्स आर परफॉर्म एंड देन व्हाट इज टेस्टेड? द कंडीशन. करेक्ट? एंड इफ द कंडीशन इज ट्रू इट विल कम बैक अगेन टू परफॉर्म द स्टेटमेंट. तो एट द बिगिनिंग इट विल परफॉर्म द स्टेटमेंट एटलीस्ट वंस एंड देन चेक द कंडीशन. Still true, come back, perform it. And if it is false, it will continue running the remaining code. So whatever is the remaining code, it will go with that. Right, guys? Okay? I hope you are understanding. So if it is false, go to the remaining code. And true, come back and again perform the statement. But can you observe it from the diagram that the statements are executed at least once? The statements are executed at least once. Okay? ठीक है? See ya. So if I'm writing, I'll give the name as loop demo. Class loop demo. Public static void main string args integer I am taking I equal to 1, then we are writing a while loop while I less than equal to 5 suppose. ठीक है, then I am printing that I system.out.println I and then I plus plus. And I told you, if you don't do I plus plus, then you are not going to reach towards the goal. Means if you do I plus plus, you are going to reach nearer and nearer to 5, and then the condition will become false and the loop will stop. But if you don't do this, then it will go into infinite loop. Right, guys? ठीक है. Now after while loop, suppose I am putting some statement like this: system.out.println all done. ठीक है. Now is it going to display from 1 till 5? Java loop demo. Java loop demo. Is it printing from 1 till 5 and then all done? Right? Then see guys, like, can we shift it, this part here, I plus plus. If I shift it, will it still print 1 to 5?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Clear? It will first print and then increment. Means it will give the value and then increment. Give the value and then increment. Okay? So still you will get the same result. You can compile it. Compile and see. Still it is giving. Suppose I switch it to this place. Tell me, I am writing 0 and here I am writing I plus plus. Getting? Okay. But only one change I am doing, I am making it less than 5. Instead of less than equal, I am writing less than. And I am removing this I plus plus from here. Will it still display 1 to 5? I 0. Is 0 less than 5? Yes, come inside, but when it has come inside, it is already incremented. So it has become 1. Right? Again, is 1 less than 5? Yes, but when it has come inside, it has become 2. Same way, when I is 4, is 4 less than 5? Yes, but when it comes inside, it has already become 5. Getting? Because it is post-increment. See you. This code also will give you the same result. So what is my intention? My intention is that to tell you, you can produce the same result by different ways. Getting? And suppose at the beginning only if the condition is false, will it run that code for at least one time? No. It will be executed how many times? 0 times. See ya. All done. Why? Because the condition at the beginning only is false. Okay. Now we'll try to convert it to do while loop. Okay, guys. See ya. I'll put do I, right? Then I'm writing I plus plus. And here while loop I less than equal to 5. Now, as there are two statements, I have to put it in a bracket. Okay? As there are two statements, I have to put it in a bracket. The first statement, I equal to 1, that is the initialization part. This is the statement and this is the updation part, increment or decrement. For loop gives you this all thing systematically in one line only. The increment part, the condition testing part, sorry, the initialization part, the condition testing part, and the increment decrement in one statement only you can do. ठीक है? Okay, so I equal to 1, print 1, make it 2, is 2 less than equal to 5? Yes. Come back, print 2, make it 3, 3 less than equal to 5? Yes. Print 3, make it 4, print 4, make it 5, print 5, make it 6. But is 6 less than equal to 5? No, the condition is false and it will stop. Getting? Still, will it give the same result? Yes. Okay? And in this also, suppose I would have shifted this I plus plus here, there is no need to have two statements. So can I remove this bracket? Now, will the bracket be compulsory or no? Will it run now? Do while. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Clear? See. Still, will it work? Yes. So there is no such compulsion that you have to put a bracket for do while loop. For do while loop, we put bracket only if there are more than one statement. And in this, if suppose I give some condition which is false, then also will it run this statement at least once?
Yes, sir.
It is exit control. No? So I is 10. Will it print 10? Make it 11. But is 11 less than equal? No. False. All done. But you will get output at least once. See ya. I think I have not saved it. See, is it giving at least output once? That is 10. Clear to you. Right, guys? So do while loop, while loop is clear to you. Then we have for loop also. And in Java, there is one more for loop called as for each, which is specially for arrays. So I'll tell you that later. First, we'll talk about the normal standard for loop. Okay. For loop is also called as while loop and do while loop are called as logically controlled. Getting? Because they are decided on the condition. Till the condition doesn't become false, it will go on. Getting? And normally for loops are used for some fixed number of iterations. Getting? Means when we know that the number of iterations are n times. So generally we go for a for loop. So for loop are called as enumeration controlled. Enumeration means list of values. And only for that list of values the loop will go on. Getting? Okay. So fixed values from 1 till 10 or 10 till 1 or 1 till 10 with a gap of 2, whatever. Okay. Now for loop also come under entry controlled only. Yeah? For loop is also entry controlled. Means here also the condition is tested at the beginning. Okay. Now how the syntax of for loop is. See here. For, then the first part is initialization. Okay. Along with declaration you can do. Then the condition. Termination condition, and then the increment or decrement part, which is called as updation. But it is updation of what? Loop controlling variable. Your loop controlling variable is updated here. Okay, so that eventually the condition will become false. Eventually means in the near future the condition will become false. And here also, you can have one statement or more than one. If it is one statement, no need to put a block. If there are more than one, put a block. Agreed, guys? Okay. Working. See here. Now, this initialization can be along with declaration also. That is the specialty of Java. That you can do the initialization as well as declaration. The first thing what will be done? Okay, in a for loop, whenever you write a for loop, okay, for, three parts are there. And all the three parts are optional. Huh? Please understand, all the three parts are optional. Means first part, second part, third part. Nothing is written. This is also a valid for loop. If I write for semicolon, semicolon, and some code, this is an infinite loop. It's an infinite for loop. No initialization, no condition, no increment, decrement. Getting? But this is also a legal for loop. Okay, all these true false statements, please remember, in MCQs they will ask you all such true false statement. Okay, so for, right, then you will have first part, that is initialization part, the condition part, the body part, and the increment or decrement part. So very first this initialization is done. The initialization is done at the very beginning. And this part is executed only once in the whole life of that for loop. In the entire for loop life, this part is executed only once. Then it will come to this condition part. Second. Okay. Now, if this condition, it has to be a Boolean expression only, remember. Same like while loop, do while loop. Java is very strict type. Here you have to write a Boolean expression only. And if the test is true, it will come inside, perform the statement, getting? And then it will come to increment, decrement. Getting? And after doing increment, decrement, it will again come to the condition. Okay? Again, if the condition is true, it will come to perform this code block, increment, decrement, again test the condition, this will go on. And if the condition comes false, then it will come to the following code. Getting? So how the working of the for loop is, that is clear to you, working of the for loop. But only remember this first part, you can do initialization as well as declarations also. But if you do declaration, the scope of that variable is only for the for loop. When the for loop is over, that variable is died. Each and every word, each and every line which I'm telling, and hear it carefully. Getting? And if you're not able to understand it, then again I have put the recording on YouTube. Please go through it. You'll understand because I've told at a very basic level. So elementary level I'm telling. Getting? And still if you're not understanding, please contact me. I'm there to help you. Correct? But these are all the foundations of your programming language. If these all concepts are clear, you can write your logics, no? You can build your logics. Right? So concept is clear. In this first part, what can be there? Initialization as well as declaration. But if you do declaration and initialization, then that variable scope is only for the for loop. When the for loop is over, the variable is died. Getting? So first part done is initialization. Then it will come for checking the condition. If the condition is true, it will enter in the for body, perform the statements, and come to this third part, that is updation part, increment or decrement. Means here what we are doing is, we are updating the loop controlling variable in such a way that in the near future, the condition will become false. Getting? So after updation, again come to check the condition, true, again perform, again update, going on, and means this part will go on. 3, 4, 5 will go on. Okay? So 5, true, 3, then 4. Again come to 5, true, 3, 4, going on. And if this condition is false, it will come to the following code and continue with the remaining. Getting, guys? Okay? And already I have told you that this condition has to be Boolean only. Okay? Just a quick example I'll show you of a for loop. Now, tell me, can I do initialization and declaration both in the for loop beginning part? Yes, that is the benefit. So you can declare the variable and initialize also. You have declared variable I of type integer and initialize it with 1. But this I life is only for the for loop. For loop start, I is born, and for loop over, I is died. So the life of I is only restricted to the for loop. Okay, then I am writing a basic condition I less than equal to 5. Then I am writing the updation part, because if you don't write updation, If you don't give this updation, then your loop controlling variable will not approach to this end value. It will not reach near and near to the end. And if it doesn't reach to end, the condition won't become false and the loop will go into infinite. Isn't it? Now tell me, system.out.println. ठीक है, तो एट द बिगिनिंग विल इट डिक्लेयर एंड इनिशियलाइज आई बाय वन, दिस इज द फर्स्ट पार्ट, ओनली वंस इन द होल लाइफ ऑफ दैट फॉर लूप. ठीक है, तो आई इज इनिशियलाइज टू वन, देन इट कम्स हियर, इज वन लेस देन इक्वल टू फाइव, यस ट्रू, इट विल कम इनसाइड इनसाइड अ बॉडी, आई टोल्ड यू ए बी सी डी, करेक्ट, तो ए बी ट्रू, सी सी मीन्स दिस कोड. So it will print 1 and then increment. Come here. It is 2 now. 2 less than equal to 5. Yes. Print 2. Come here. Make it 3. This will go on. So somewhere it will print 5. Increment 6. When it comes here, is 6 less than equal to 5? No. The condition is false. And then it will come to all done. Right? See ya. Is this program also printing 1 till 5 only? Yes. Okay? But can I access that I outside for loop? If I want to check, once the for loop is over, what is the value of I? Actually, value of I is 6. But when the for loop got over, I is died. So can I access I over here? Will it give an error? What do you say, guys? Will it give error or will it display 6? Yes, guys, I'm expecting the answer from you.
It will display 6.
It will display 6? Means you didn't understood the entire thing what I told. Just now, I was explaining you all, if you are doing the declaration and the initialization of this loop controlling variable at the beginning, here I explained also, I told that once the for loop is over, is that variable died? Is the variable scope only for that for loop? Yes or no?
Sir.
Right? So the scope of that for loop is, sorry, scope of that variable is only for that for loop. Once the for loop is over, the variable is destroyed. So can I access this I after for loop? If you would have done it like this.
No, sir.
Tell me. Integer I, and then I am writing here integer I. Integer I, and then in the for loop I am just initializing it. Loop is going on and then printing. Now will it give an error or will it print 6? I is already declared. Here you are just initializing. You are using it in the for loop and for loop over and you are checking the value of I, which is supposed to be 6. Now it will display 6. Now it won't give an error. But if you are writing the declaration and initialization both in the for loop, then after the for loop is over, can I access I? Can I access I?
No, sir.
No, so that's what I'm asking you. Why I cannot access? Because I is died once the for loop is over. Because you have declared the for loop I, initialization and declaration, both at the beginning of the for loop. So once the for loop is over, this I is destroyed. So how can you access it outside the for loop? Getting? Try doing it. See here. Is it giving an error? Is it giving an error? That symbol I cannot find symbol I. Getting? Because it will try to search that I in main scope. But in main scope, there is no I declared. I is declared within the for loop scope. Getting? And suppose you would have declared it here, and here you are just doing the initialization. You understanding? Here you are doing just initialization. Now will it give error or will it display 6? No error, and it will display 6. Getting? So please understand, the concepts are very important. Getting or no? Correct? So it's really important.
Yes, sir.
Can we have multiple declarations also in a for loop? 100% valid. You can write multiple declarations, like I equal to 1 comma j equal to 1 is valid. Can we have such multiple initializations? Yes, multiple initialization and declaration. Okay, see here in this for loop only. All possible things I'm going to ask you now. Integer I equal to 1 comma j equal to 1. Can I write I less than equal to 5 and I less than, sorry, j less than equal to 10. And then I am writing I plus plus, j plus plus. And then I am printing value of I also, then a tab, and then value of j also. Getting? So here also are multiple variables getting initialized also and declared also. Multiple variables, I and j, both are 1 and 1. Both are initialized to 1, 1, declared and initialized. Now it will come for condition. Now remember, it is and. And means when both are true, then only true. Correct? When both are true, then only true. So both are 1 less than 5, 1 less than 10. True. Come inside, print it. Will it print 1, 1? Yes or no? Will it print 1, 1? And then will it increment both by 1? 2, 2. Getting? Is 2 less than equal to 5? Is 2 less than equal to 10? Yes. 2, 2. Again, both increment. Both printed. Both incremented. Both printed, because still both the conditions are true. Both incremented, both printed. Now this becomes 6, 6. But when this becomes 6, 6, this is false. Is 6 less than equal to 5, guys?
No.
No. So this is false, and as it is short circuit, will it check this part? No need only, because and is a short circuit operation. If first part is false, entire false. Getting? So the whole condition comes false and it stops. So does it stop at 5, 5 only? Means by printing 5, 5, does it stop?
Yes.
Yes or no? Clear? I hope you got it. Right? Okay? So why? Because the condition written is and in and, when one is false, the entire thing is false. Right? So if I give you this, does it stop at 5, 5 and it display all done?
Yes.
Right? Okay. But tell me, guys, instead of and, if I write or over here, what will happen? When I'm writing or, okay, it has printed 5, 5, both have become 6, 6. This is false because I has become 6. Getting? But is this condition yet true?
Yes.
Yes. And as it is or, when one is true, the result is true. So still will it print 6, 6? Yes or no? Make it 7, 7. Print 7, 7. then make it 8 8, print that 8 8, make it 9 9, print that 9 9, then make it 10 10, print that 10 10, make it 11 11, and now when it becomes 11 11, this was the already false, this was long back false, getting, and now this also has become false, and therefore now it will stop. Now in this case, till where it is going to print? Till 5 5 or till 10 10?
Till 10 10,
because it is OR. In OR, if one of the condition is true, the result is true. Getting? Hope it is clear to you. See, is it printing till both 10 10? So please understand. Now, other point I have to tell you, like, you can do multiple initialization and multiple declaration. But if you are doing multiple initialization as well as declaration, it has to be of the same type. This is invalid. Huh? Like, you want one variable of integer and another of float. Getting? This is not allowed. Huh? This is an invalid for loop. You understanding, guys? Huh. If you have declared I first, float, and then in a for loop you are doing only initialization. Okay? Is valid. You understanding? This is valid, this is not. Means multiple initialization and declaration is allowed. Okay, but of the same data type, right? Multiple initialization and declaration is allowed, which we did here. See, getting I and J, multiple initialization, multiple declaration, but both were of integer, therefore allowed. But they are of different data type, it is not allowed. Therefore, it gives invalid, right? Okay, and if it is declared already and only initialization, then it is allowed of different type. Like this is float, this is integer, this is okay. Because you have already declared, now you are only doing initialization. Is it clear to you or no?
Yes, sir.
Right? Okay. So I hope you got it. So tell me, if this is a standard for loop, integer I equal to 1, I less than equal to 5, I plus plus, I am printing this I. ठीक है? This is one. This is one for loop. Okay? Now, the same thing I am writing in some other way. Okay? Tell me, I am writing integer I first equal to 1. And here I am writing for semicolon I less than equal to 5. I plus plus, and then SOP, system.out.println I. Will this do? Are they both equal? Are they both same? Are they both going to function the same way?
Yes, sir, I think.
I think nahin. It will. Clear? Right? Both are valid. Only here what I have done, the initialization part I have done already, and here only condition testing, increment and body I am writing. But some may ask, like, what is the use if you are going to write like this, then what is the use of for loop? Because this is the most sophisticated, compact, simplified for loop. This is near to while loop only. Getting? Now tell me, if I write int I equal to 1 for semicolon I less than equal to 5. This part also I have skipped. Okay? And system.out.println I plus plus. What do you say? Is this also the same for loop? My question is, are these all three for loops going to produce the same result?
Yes, sir.
What say, guys, others also? Or if I write int I equal to 1 for semicolon semicolon Inside I am writing if I greater than phi break. Otherwise I am writing system.out.println I plus plus. Will this for loop also produce the same result? I am writing I equal to 1, initialize. All three parts are not there. Initialization already done. Condition testing here you are doing. Body and increment. So directly it will jump inside. Okay, condition is yet true, no. So it will print 1, make it 2. Getting? And somewhere I will become 6, then it will break. Break means come out of the loop. So will this for loop also print 1 to 5? 1 to 5, 1 to 5 and 1 to 5. All are equivalent. But obviously the first one is the elegant one. The compact one, the simplified one, the elegant one. More clean, more readable. Everything systematically you have written in one line only. The initialization, the condition, the body, and the increment, decrement. Is it clear to you or no? Okay? So just give me quick confirmation. If all the things till here are clear to you people. Sure. Okay, Sanket is saying yes, no issues. So now, can you people write that whole code which I told you to do? Okay, in this exercise, we were supposed to do sum and average to produce the sum of 1 to some upper bound, example 100. And also compute and display the average, and the output should look like this. The sum is, the average is. Okay? I'll create a new file, I'll save it. I'll give the name as sum and average. Sum and average dot java. Okay? Now, if you want to accept the upper bound, example 100 they have given. But if you want to accept the upper bound from the user, then you have to give scanner class to java.util.scanner. Class sum and average. Okay? Public static void main string args. Then we'll create a scanner class object. Yesterday I told you. To that you have to pass system.in. Then I'll give one message, system.out.print, when a prompt message, enter n. That is the upper bound. I'll accept it s.next int. I hope you remember all these things. Okay, these were all clear to you. Now we have to find out the sum. So I'll create one variable, sum equal to 0. Okay. I'll declare it and initialize it. Now we will start with a for loop. For integer I equal to 1, I less than equal to n, I plus plus. Do you agree? N is the upper bound. You have to start from 1 till that upper bound. Getting? And you'll keep adding that I in sum. Okay? So what you'll do is, you'll write sum plus equal to I. Is sum plus equal to I same as sum is equal to sum plus I? Sum plus equal to I. I have taken this compound arithmetic operator. No doubt I have told you. In the past I have told. And this is this compound arithmetic. This is only having one speciality. That here only implicit narrowing happens. Otherwise Java doesn't do automatic narrowing. Only this is the situation where automatic narrowing takes place. Getting? So first time what will be your sum? Will it be 0? Sum will be 0 and I will be 1. Will it add them? 0 plus 1, 1. And will it make it as sum? So next time sum will be 1 and I will be 2. Will it add them? 1 plus 2, 3, keep it in sum. And your I will be 3. Getting? Then, they both are added and it is kept in sum only. And I becomes 4. And this will go on. Getting? Will this go on till end time? Okay? Now we have to display that sum first. System.out.println in that pattern. The pattern is the sum is. Right? See here. The sum is and plus sum. Can I concatenate it? That is the facility of Java given. You can concatenate a string with anything. Is this sum, which is integer, going to get converted into a string? And then string plus string will become string. Now the second part is average. Okay? But if I write the average is plus, and here I just write sum divided by n, will it produce the expected result? Getting? Will it produce? No doubt division will be done first, because division is having higher priority. Division will have higher priority. Getting? See here, from 1 till 100 when you'll divide, so you'll get 5050. Divide me sum. 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus, when you add it till 100, you'll get this as a sum. And when you'll divide it with 100, okay, actual answer should come as 50.5. Getting? But it will give you only the quotient part, that is 50. You understanding? Because sum is an integer and n is also an integer. According to Java rule, integer divided by integer is integer divided by integer is integer. Therefore, the answer is 50. It won't give you 50.5. So, can we use some casting mechanism? Temporarily, can I cast it to float? What do you say, guys? Okay. So, is this sum going to get casted to float? First division or first casting? First division or first casting will be done. First casting, because it's a unary operator. So sum is temporarily converted into float. Getting? So it will become float 5050.0. And now when you divide it by 100, it will become 50.5. That is converted into string, and string join with this string, and you'll get the final answer. Do you agree, all of you? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
See, JAVAC, sum and average, Java, sum and average. It will ask you for the input. I'll give 100. Is it giving the result as the sum is 5050 and the average is 50.5? Try doing it. Try removing that casting and you'll see the different result. Getting? See ya. But obvious, now I know you're having faith in me. Getting? Because you have faith, therefore that is the reason till the end you're connected. Otherwise, like others which keep disconnecting, and there are all once in a blue moon faces also. So Java, sum and average, see the answer. If I give 100, can you see, is the result only 50? Okay, so hope it is clear, because integer divided by integer is integer. Is the question clear to you? Okay. Now they're saying that you have to do it the same thing, the sixth one, modify the program to use while loop instead of for loop, and try doing it using do while loop also. Okay? So can you modify it? Yes or no? The same question, if I tell you to do it using which loop? While loop. And I tell you to do it using do while loop instead of for loop. So can you do the changes in it? ठीक है? So we will see this in the next session, how to do the changes, and then we'll see some examples of nested loops, okay? And then we will see the concept of break and continue, right? And then we will start with arrays concept.
Yes.
Okay, arrays also is going to be a very important thing, okay? ठीक है, तो for today we have to stop all of you. Thank you. Please take